everybody. What's going on? My name is Blue, and welcome to the channel. I just want to say, first off, you know, Happy New Year's. I hope you guys had a great New Year's and a great holiday season. If you guys don't celebrate any holidays, I still hope that you guys had a great winter season. And yeah, I'm really excited to be back making content for you guys, and I'm really hoping that I can make as much content as possible for you guys this year. All right, so let's jump right into it. So you guys are here because of the new expansion, the Mountain of Eternal Winter. That just got released a few weeks ago in Korea, and we've since then gotten some extra grind spots and some additional items in the game. So this video will kind of just go over some of the extra grind spots that got added and some of the items that got added. And we'll have other videos that are more specific on the grind spots. You know, we'll have a specific video for each individual grind spot. As I can do more content with it, or as I just grind it more, I can give you some more accurate information. Because as you guys know, when it comes to grinding and then just new expansions and all that, there's a lot of rumors that can get released, and rumors suck. Okay, so the first lot that we will talk about is the Winter Tree Fossil Hunting Grounds. This place is one of the easiest grind spots in the new region. So the tower is the winter fossil tree spot. Basically, I just call it the tower spot or something of that nature, because it's literally just a tower defense spot. Like I said earlier, you interact with the tower and you kill the mobs. It lasts about 15 minutes long. At least when I did it, I did the hard mode, and this is kind of what you're seeing right here. And it lasts about 15 minutes long. At the end, you get this giant bear. You kill it, it's like a polar bear or something. You kill it, and after you kill it, there's a chance to get the major boss that can spawn there, or the snow trolls, it's actually called like Jade Forest, but I call them snow trolls because it's kind of what they are. But yeah, there's a chance to for a giant boss to spawn in both those areas, and you can get an ember, or so I'm told. I've yet to actually encounter that boss, so I can't say for certain. But it does seem like, from what I've been told by other players, that you should be able to get it from that. Again, I will be doing like 10 to 20 hours in each of the spots in another video, and hopefully that can give you a little bit more in-depth on each spot. But yeah, let's go ahead and talk about the item drops. So, the red circular glowy orb things that you see, these are the ignore resist, the materials you need for the Aluka's ignore resist crystals. They can drop in a majority of the spots. There's only like one spot that they can't drop in. But for the tower drops, they can drop here. And then the blue kind of potion looking thing you have is actually what you need to create this new spirit perfume. You combine it with the spirit perfume and you can get the new spirit perfume. Then you have the green resist, the adamantine crystals, but, well, not adamantine. They are the resist crystals for the other type of resistances that you put in your shoes. And yes, you can turn these into RBF versions. No new special recipe, you just need these new crystals. Armor and weapon stones, that's a given for everywhere. Dragon scale fossils, I'm assuming it has to do with the lore. I'll be honest, I haven't done the story quest yet, but my guess is it's probably something with the lore. The trash loot there is only 5,620 silver, so it's not that much trash in terms of like value of the trash, but you know, it is what it is. Then you have ancient spirit powder and kaffir stones. That's pretty much in every single spot. I haven't grinded extensively in the tower drop or this tower defense area, honestly, because after 15 minutes, the tower gets like cleansed and you have to find a new tower. And I don't know how long it takes for the tower to finish, so I kind of just didn't feel like, when I did try it, I didn't feel like waiting or looking around, because I tried to look around, but all the other towers were cleansed, so I was just like, okay, whatever, time to go to the next spot. The new thing that they added this week was actually the erased witch's mark, or something of that nature. Basically, you need this to get into the Erethea's Oblivion. Well, you can get into Erethea's Oblivion just by going through the portal, but you can't do anything in there unless you have this mark. This will allow you to actually do the trial, which is like what they call like the grind spot. It's like a trial. And then after you complete the trial, then you go into the treasure room and you can interact and exchange it for the RNG box. Okay, so this is Mrowek's Labyrinth. This is an interesting spot. You can only have up to six players per channel grind here. The way that that works is once you go here, you actually have to enter a portal to get to the grind spot. And again, after if six players are in there, then you can no longer enter. As you can see, once you walk up to the portal, you can interact with it. And you can choose to explore the labyrinth. If there's six players, you won't be able to enter. You must be at least level 60 to enter. And it is a 280 AP recommended grind spot. All the spots are actually recommended at 280 AP. The Winter Tree Fossil Hunting Grounds, I just call it the Tower Defense Area, is recommended 280, but there's an easy mode for 250 AP. These guys, I call them the Snow Trolls or Jade Starlight Forest. This is recommended 280 AP as well. But in my opinion, they're all relatively easy-ish to kill. These mobs here at the tower defense area, the star, the Jade, the Winter Tree Fossil, are probably the easiest to kill. So once you enter, basically you will get teleported in if there's not six people already in the grind spot. Each person has their own little labyrinth they're at, and they just hit this thing to start spawning the mobs. Once a mob spawn, you pretty much have to kill the mobs. After about 15 minutes or so, you can go to the next area. And once the boss spawns, you interact with the portal to, instead of going to the next area, you go to the boss room. And that's basically how this spot it works. When you get these yellow crystals, you can exchange it with the boss. After the boss dies, there's an NPC you can exchange them to for RNG boxes. The RNG box and drop the flame, ember, or anything in the spot. Anything that drops there. Honestly, one of my favorite spots, if I'm being like 100% honest. I don't know why I like this spot so much. But yeah, it's the labyrinth. Maybe because it's really chill. Because in the labyrinth, like I said earlier, you don't really have to worry about other players coming in and trying to take your spot or anything like that because it's literally locked to six people per channel. The only time you actually see other players is if you, or once you start killing the boss, because the boss room is like six players are there and they drop up to six drops for all the players. So this is the only really time you have the interaction with other players on your channel. Yes, you can PvP there. Yes, there's GVG. You could flag up. So just be weary of that. If I've had some players literally see that I'm grinding here on stream. And they will swap to my channel so they can find me during the boss and try to kill me and prevent me from exchanging the crystals. It can get pretty frustrating, not gonna lie. But that's the nature of being in a PvP guild. So this spot has the Aluka's Ignore Resist and the regular like resist crystals. But you also can get this golden kind of orb. It's the thing that you need to actually craft the food and the elixirs. As you can see, you don't get that blue potion thing for the spirit perfume, but you do get this. Now, for those of you guys who are life skillers, if you want to craft these foods and elixirs, you don't have to grind here. This thing actually you can be put on the marketplace, which is kind of nice. I think right now it's selling for about 9 million silver on KR. It's not hit the max price yet, but I don't know if it will because it's starting to sit on the market around 9 million. But yeah, it's kind of cool. So like you don't have to grind if you want to make the new food, but it's probably easier, and if I'm being honest, it's probably one of the second easiest spots to grind. And again, you don't have to worry about dueling for spot or anything like that. Just hop in a channel, kill some mobs. It is what it is. All right. The trash loot here is 9,870 silver. It's not as much as the snow trolls. However, so far from my experience, I've grinded here for about 15, 20 hours now. I've averaged around 200 to 300 million silver per hour, and when I talk to my guildmates, they're around the same gear as me, and they grind the snow troll spots. They say that they average around 200, 300 mil an hour as well. So, if that's any inclination as to how good a spot is, it seems like they might be pretty similar. Again, though, I will be doing more hours at each spot. I'll be trying to do 50 hours per spot and making videos on them to give you a little bit more in-depth detail on each spot. But yeah, this has somehow become one of my favorite spots. It's super chill. I can literally just do this on stream and I don't really have to worry about anybody trying to come stream snipe for for the most part. Again, sometimes they can get to my channel and find me at the boss. But yeah, it's actually super chill. And again, you can get the embers and flames. I have yet to get a flame or ember from the actual mobs. However, they can drop from the boss. And the yellow crystals that you get from the elites in this area, when you exchange them for the RNG box, the RNG box has a chance of dropping the flame or ember. So it seems like technically you may not necessarily be able to get the flame or ember directly from a mob, but in a way you kind of can, because you kill the elites, you get the crystal, you exchange the crystal once you get to the boss room, and when you exchange it, you have a chance of getting the flame or ember. So it's like, it's kind of like technically you can't get it directly as a regular drop, but you get the crystal, and the crystal kind of acts as a chance to get the regular, get the flame or ember, or you just kill a boss and you get lucky and you can get one. Again, ancient spirit powder and kaffir stones, and every spot in the game, or every spot in the mountain of endless winter, sorry, every spot there can drop the erased witch's mark, which allows you to enter Erethea's Oblivion. Okay, so the last grind spot that got added originally with the Mountain of Endless Winter is the Jade Starlight Forest. This one is, I call the Snow Trolls. If you guys are on the stream and I mentioned the Snow Trolls, this is the grind spot. The trash is 20,140 per trash. And you get a decent amount of trash per kill. And you can also drop the armor and weapon stones, the dragon scale fossils, ancient spirit powder, kaffirs, and embers or flames from some of the mobs. The other thing that you can drop is, again, the item that you can use to create the new spirit perfume. And yeah, so they recently added, just this week, the Erethea's Oblivion. And every single grind spot in the Mountain of Endless Winter can drop the item that you need to enter the Oblivion. The item is called the Erased Witch's Mark. But yeah, they can drop literally everywhere, which is pretty cool. But yeah, so going back to the Snow Trolls, it's pretty interesting. Basically, the way that it works is there's like a pack of 3 to 5 mobs in one little pack. You will attack, kill them. But they're actually really strong. Think of it like orcs, where they're naturally a lot tankier, but there are these little lamps, or these little items that are pretty much just around the same grind, around the spot that the mobs will be, and you kill it and it'll debuff the mobs or give you extra buffs. The other part of it, the other like mechanic in this spot, is when you kill a mob, it will explode doing damage to the other mobs, so it helps you kill them a little bit faster, helps your clear speed. Most players average around 200 to 300 mil per hour here. I will have another video like going through it probably in more detail and showing a few different rotations. But yeah, it's a pretty interesting spot. But again, the money is not like the very best. You know, if you go to Elvia, you can make 500 mil an hour. If you go to other spots, you can still make 400 to 500 mil an hour. But the difference here is, again, the ember or the flame. You need this to make the Fallen God helmet or Labyrinth helmet. I honestly suck at pronouncing it, but I just refer to it as a Fallen God helmet. You can technically buy these off the market, but realistically, your chance of winning a pre-order is typically it's higher than actually succeeding pin on a 50 stack. Realistically, you're going to have to grind for it, which is why the money isn't as good, because it's kind of like the second reason to grinding here. It's not really for the money, it's more for the flame, and anybody who's working on progression pretty much more or less has to grind for it. At least in the first few months, you probably won't see a lot of these on the market. You still don't see the Flame of Despair even sitting on the market almost in any region. So that's kind of why the money's not as high, at least for now. Who knows? Maybe in the future things change. Yeah. Okay, let's talk about Erethea's Oblivion. This is the entrance, and I will show you on the map where it's at. So this is Mountain of Endless Winter, and this is the Oblivion spot. This shows that it's 290 AP recommended with 250 is the easy mode. There's like two different modes, easy or hard. So as you see, there's a portal. When you're further away, the door is closed. And as you approach it, right, the door will open up. You can enter inside of this area for like without anything. You don't need anything to enter the area. However, in order to actually do the dungeon or whatever you want to call it, you need an item that is called the Erased Witch's Mark. They drop in every other grind spot in the Mountain of Endless Winter. It's this item here. They can drop literally every other grind spot of the Mountainless of Endless Winter. Wow, I can't even say it right. The Mountain of Endless Winter. And once you get it, when you're here, you will see some lights and you can interact with the different runes on the ground. Each rune will have its door, a corresponding door. There's a blue rune, as you can see here. There's a blue icon up here. There's a purple gem right here, orange, and this one is actually, there you go. It's kind of like green, right? The way that it works is you will be able to interact with the door, and you can choose which doors you go in. They will have separate trials. The trial will pretty much have you kill mobs, more or less, and after you do enough trials, you will be able to enter the Golden Treasure Room. The Golden Treasure Room will have treasures, chests are along the ground, as well as one giant treasure chest. When you interact with the giant treasure chest, it will allow you to get the actual RNG box, I call it, for the Erased Witch's Mark. You exchange it. When you exchange it, you can open it up for various items. The different items include things such as the ember and the flame. You can also get the items you needed to make the new foods, elixirs, or the new perfume. And then you can also get, again, the different resist crystals or the item you need to make the Aluka's ignore resist. Along with those, you get armor and weapon stones, Kaffirs, ancient spirit powder, embers, and the flame. The mobs here drop a 24,350 trash item. I don't know exactly how often or how much money you can make, but I will definitely be grinding here on stream and trying to get the items to go and do this Oblivion, Erethea's Oblivion on stream with you guys. I will make a separate video, again, explaining each individual grind spot to a little bit more specifics. Now, when you kill the treasure chest, so once you actually exchange the witch's mark for the RNG box, you can then kill the treasure chests that are on the ground, and the treasure chest can drop these different items as well. So you get like extra chances, so to speak. Yeah, that is the Mountain of Endless Winter. And once you're here, you can't open the map or anything. You pretty much have to leave. You interact with this like little book tablet thing, and you click on this to escape. But yeah, that's the Mountain of Endless Winter. Again, I'll be doing this stuff. I'll be testing each spot on stream. So if you guys want to check out the stream, feel free to. It's twitch.tv/itmeblue. It'll be showing up somewhere on the screen right now. I changed my name. for those of you guys who don't know, I guess this is just a little extra. If you guys are done with Mountain of Endless Winter, or if you guys only came for that, this is the end of that video. This part, I'm just going to explain kind of why I changed my name. For those of you guys who don't know, I did get a job as a community manager for Kakao Games. And since I was obviously active on like the social media and whatnot, they asked me kind of if I can change my name from BDOBloo, which, you know, makes sense because, I mean, Kakao no longer works with BDO, so it is kind of weird having my name as a competitor's, you know. So, I mean, it was understandable, so I switched my name. However, I no longer work for Kakao. I quit December 31st. A lot of things led up to that, and that's a whole video in itself. So if you guys want to know more about that, stay tuned. I'll have a video. All right, I'll see you guys on stream. Peace.